Welcome back to Managing Asia's Stable Stewardship. Before the break, we looked at how a privately held family business forged a path of long-term stability. Up next, we look at how a listed company does the same. We speak with YTL Corp's Francis Yeoh. YTL Corp was founded in Malaysia in 1955 as a construction company. Today, it's a global integrated infrastructure developer. Helming the empire is the third generation, Francis Yeoh, who started working in the family business when he was a teenager.
I started at 16, was still in school. My father already threw me to the deep end of the business.
That early learning paid off. In 1988, Francis took over the day-to-day running of the business from his father. And under his stewardship, YTL grew from a single listed entity to a conglomerate of five separately listed companies. So how does stable stewardship work in such an organization? Tantri, thank you so much for talking to me today. It's such a pleasure. Now, we know YTL is one of Malaysia's biggest conglomerates with history spanning over 60 years. As the third generation heading the family business, what would you say is the secret to such an enduring legacy?
From day one, I always, together with my siblings, thought we must have businesses that are very sustainable and very long-term in nature so that we don't suffer this third generation curse. So we go about, set about innovatively looking for ideas and challenging the status quo of businesses. And one thing I learned from young, from my father and my grandfather, is don't worship short-term thinking. Always invest in people, always invest in technology as it changes, be as long-term thinking as we can. That's probably the secret, long-term thinking.
How do you balance the short-term thinking of the markets with the long-term objectives and goals of the family? Has it made decision-making challenging at times?
The long-term thinking is very important. When we fear our third generation curse, one of the Gordian knot ways of making sure we are not guilty of this curse is to find businesses with concessions in perpetuity so that we can pass it to the next generation beyond even our physical lifetime. And that's why all our businesses have got footprints and templates. For example, Wessex Water is a concession in perpetuity. Our Sarawak Power is freehold, so there's no limit to the concessions. Even our REITs, we've got assets of 50 years and above, for example. So we think long-term, where the revenues and the are not going to be impeded by short-term cycles.
When you look at the sort of business disruptions caused by the pandemic, has it forced you to re-strategize, rethink, so as to ensure the long-term survival of YTL businesses? Have you had to change your strategy in any way?
Well, we have to dataize our assets more now. For example, in shopping malls, in the past, we've got 50 million customers in all our malls, visiting all our malls. And we are doing very well. The rental rates are fantastic because they are all prime assets from Australia to Malaysia to Singapore. And we should do very well, right? Because we are in the prime and people keep coming, 50 million people. What's there to worry about? But then you did not do what you should do. You should have introduced an omni-channel of online sales. You should have total detail of this 50 million customers that walk into your mall with knowing what they like and don't like, giving them reward points if they shop with you.
So this digital business that you talk about, this dataization that you talk about, is going to be a big part of YTL's future business?
Well, yes, in Malaysia, we are already doing that because we are doing a lot of programs on communications. We have a data, YTL Communications doing very well. We are having now almost 1.5 million customers and growing. We are working with Shopee and many other groups now to extend our customer base, and we are giving reward points, and it's beginning.
Apart from going digital, you're also putting sustainability as a key focus. Why are you and your family so passionate about driving sustainability as part of the family legacy?
I always taught my children when they were young, why do you think God made such trees and flowers, etc.? And they said, well, for our eyes, for our beauty, to enjoy it. So that's what we do in every of our area, Christine. In Wessex Water, we already won the Queen's Award 3 times in a row for environmental sustainability. ERL, for example, we are taking 5 million cars off the road because it's a clean travel from the city to the airport. In every area, Christine, the whole culture of the group understands we like to do alternative energy against fossil fuel. Even Saraya now, we are doing investing heavily now on the photovoltaic in solar energy. We are going massively in this direction.
But hang on, Tan Sri, because you're in traditional businesses like cement and construction that emit harmful carbon, you know, dioxide, yes, into the environment. How exactly do you put sustainable practices in place in these traditional businesses that you have?
Yes, so we are not going to lie about cement being a big emitter of carbon dioxide. But what we can do is that we already, from many years ago, started doing alternative cement by introducing slag cement and other materials so that there will be less polluting. And we already introduced what we call that heat recovery systems.
So you're trying to reduce your carbon emission?
Yes, we try to mitigate that as much as we can. But whatever we have to employ the most fuel efficient to mitigate whatever, most efficient to mitigate against that.
The next Yeoh generation, including your own children, are now involved in various parts of the YTL businesses. Have you decided who your successor will be?
Yes, the successor issue, I think I've got 25 years because I look at Warren Buffett, he has not named one yet. So if I live till 90, ask me the same question at 90.
So have you identified the next steward or stewards that could possibly take over from you?
We already have got CEOs like in Wessex Water, in Saraya, they are all from the outside, but they are also getting older. And we are grooming younger CEOs from different businesses. There will be different CEOs. Some will be from the family, some will be not from the family. I rather suspect that the construction type of business will be within the family, the cement type, the old businesses. But for the group to be just a symbolic executive chairman or symbolic managing director, I think it's important for the family to be involved to stem their entrepreneurship and their family's commitment behind it. That their interest of the family is totally invested in.
So just let me clarify, you have identified a couple of CEOs within the various businesses, and they will be from outside, some from inside the family, but you haven't identified one single person to take over from you should you desire to retire.
Christine, if you ask me what would be my legacy, our legacy is if something happened to us, God forbid, but if something happened to all of us at one go, the company not only thrives, but continue to grow exponentially. That would be our legacy.
And finally, Tan Sri, what would you tell your children and the next generation about the sort of leadership and stable stewardship they need to provide to ensure that YTL survives through the generations?
As we are stewards, they also understand they are stewards. They are not there for the personal gratification of monetary rewards. For them is to build together what YTL stands for, you know, a force for good, to continue to glorify God, doing good works, right? In that way, prospering people in their process with a clear, clean conscience. And that's all good stuff. So why would they not want to be involved in if a company is truly like that? So I'm just so not worried of that value. I am very, very comforted that we have a very strong foundation to have exponential growth in the years to come.
Tan Sri, thank you so much for talking to me on Managing Asia. Such a pleasure.
Thank you, Christine. It's been a pleasure.
And that was YTL Corp's Francis Yeoh. Hope you've enjoyed the program. Do join me again on the next Managing Asia Stable Stewardship. I'm Christine Tan. Thanks for watching.